Welcome to this new campaign on the Age of Charlemagne DLC, which has just been released in December 2015, in case someone's watching this a long time in the future. Now, I was looking forward to this campaign because I really wanted to play Wessex. But when I heard that it was only going to be Mercia, I must admit I was a little bit disappointed, and I thought twice about actually buying it. And then I started watching some video presentations like Lionheart's Kingdom of Charlemagne and Malekith's, I think it's the Kingdom of Asturias. So I watched them with it and I thought, yeah, I could like this. And what really swung it is I watched Heir of Carthage's faction overview for the Avars. So this is my first choice. My second choice is the King of the Lombardy, because I think that's quite well situated for a fun campaign in the centre of here. But I'm going to go for the Avars. It's for two reasons. One, it's a very different faction. It's going to be a challenge in the fact that you're going to be up against all the Christian factions because they're not a Christian leader. And the other reason is that after I finish my Sassanid campaign, I want to play the Huns or one of the other Horde factions, so I need to boost up my skills with fighting with all cavalry armies. So it's going to be the Avars. If things go wrong and it's a very short campaign, I will then do Lombardy. So this could be an interesting campaign, but it could also be a very short campaign. So the Avars, the faction leader is Shirbar. I presume that's how it's pronounced. The religion is Tengrinism, which is the same as the Huns. And I won't read all this down here, but it's basically the overview of the faction. You can see the faction traits are battle experience gain, 1+100% cavalry, nose battle, post-battle casualties for cavalry units which are routed or withdrawn from the battle. That could be quite useful. I'm going to play on hard, purely and simply because I want to enjoy the campaign. I don't want to play kind of up here. I want to think, because also I've played about 10 minutes on the Lombardy campaign just out of curiosity before I did it. The initial challenge is normal, and you can see the victory objectives on this are Imperium, so you've got a short victory is Imperium level 5, long victory is Imperium level 7, and the Dominion victory is Imperium level 7, control 110 second settlements, which I would guess is virtually the entire map. So I think that's it. What I'm going to do is start the campaign. I'm going to let the video run. So enjoy the video, I'll keep quiet.
There have been many kings before you. Many names, many titles. Men who rose from nothing. Men who risked all that they love to lead by honor and virtue and inspire the common man. Do you think you're different? Somehow chosen. Who gave you the right to rule? It wasn't the people. It wasn't God. You.
took the Pannonian Basin for your home. Now that safety is threatened. To the south, the Croats have crept in, attempting to undo your hard-fought Khaganate, whilst to the north other Slavic tribes press upon you, covetous of the fertile lands under Avar control. These encroachments cannot be tolerated. To the west, the Franks are concerned with their own civil strife, but they will not be distracted forever and will turn their swords against any who do not worship their one god. It is now clear your people cannot remain solely in the Pannonian Basin. The time is coming to expand the kingdom. Italy lies to the southwest across the Po Valley, and beyond the Alps, Germania and Francia. Fearsome challenges, but you can rise to them. You must. Avar survival depends upon it. Destiny awaits beyond your proud borders, Khagan. Reach out and grasp it.
So we have to reach out and grasp our destiny. Now, this, Age of Charlemagne, the war weariness, this is something new, a new game mechanic, in the sense that, as I say, I have read this through when I had a quick look at the Lombardy campaign. The gist of it is that the longer you fight a war, the unhappier your population becomes. If you lose battles, they become very unhappy. If you win battles, you can carry on fighting a war, and they will just only be a little bit happy. That's the what I think it means, but we'll find out. Missions issued, a broken world, petty lords tear like dogs at a carcass of Europe. A true king must rise and scatter the pretenders. You have to reach Imperium level 3, which is the objective, if you remember from the introduction, of winning the campaign, and we get 5,000. So I'm going to apologise that this first turn might take a little while, because, as I say, I haven't really looked that much at the factions. So we're just going to have a look here. So we've got cunning, personal influence, earning situation. Yeah, she's okay. Influential. Plus 5 influence per turn. You're not going to have any problems with maintaining your influence. 3 like that, plus her. So, well, the heir's 8, so we've pretty weak family. What are these guys like? What motley crew have I got here? You're a landowner. So, you're a potential governor. You're a marksman, so you're a potential general. Strategist, cunning, general, landowner, strategist. Oh well, we'll just have to see. Just gonna have a look around the map now. I now have got to be aggressive, and oh, can't see it, but if you looked at the during the introduction, there was some kind of army stood down here, so I think we need to... Oh, there it is. And there are enemy. So let's have a look at diplomacy. In some ways, I wouldn't mind getting peace, so but... nope. So it looks like we're going to have to try and...
Do not waste time if we on can pleasantries get... and babble.
Well, might be able to get a bit of cash out of these guys.
Our purse is not...
I'm just gonna... Oh, I'll just try.
I do not think I will be...
Reason I'm trying to get non-aggression for these guys is that
speak
I don't want
quickly
them
and well. Speak ill or slowly
coming
and
down
your
and...
tongue to the dogs.
See if we can get... Nope. Maybe they go for 300.
For the good,
yep, that gives us a bit of extra cash. Yeah, I don't want these guys barreling down. I'm quite happy because, like that says, is the thing. So we don't have that much money. Let's have a look at the settlements. So we seem to have two settlements. I've already got there. Don't have a lot of food. That's actually got negative food. Not going to get trade with anyone. So can we get trade with anyone?
My time is better spent feasting and hunting than listening. So be quick.
Be welcome, and may God bless your words with appropriate speed.
No, we're not going to get any trade to start with. So I think my inclination is, because this has got negative food, there's a farm there that's maxed out. What's this? So let's go through this properly. So we've got a long haul, which gives us levy archers, levy spearmen, Avar horse archers, which are going to be the backbone of the army. We've got Avar lancers and tribesmen. So obviously Pannonia is the main recruitment area. We've got a manor here that's consuming food, that's giving us -5. That's a long way off. I'm going to knock that down, to be honest. There's no point, because this is giving us squalor. It's all right, it's giving us going to give us 350 from thing. We've got a gold mine here, that's good. We've got religion here. Public order. Public order's pretty cruddy here. Let's do it. I'm a bit worried about this, guys. Get this army over. I think we're going to have to build up an army pretty quickly. So, I think we're... What's these guys? These are horse archers. They're expensive. Oh, they're pretty expensive. These are the tribesmen. They've actually got ammunition as well. Well, that could be good. Let's get... One of those. Got an archer. Well, we can only get three of those. So. And I think what I'm going to do here is actually raise an army. Get my free general up. And what can we recruit here? Let's just get in. You know, these guys are pretty cheap, so. Yeah, I'm just going to raise an army there. So. Because I'm a bit worried about this guy coming straight in at us. Right, so what does that leave me with here? Sanitation. Public order. This is another feature. Which thing is that when you create a province, they have an adjacent effect. In the sense, if you look there, that the public order goes there. So I'm going to go for that. I don't think I can do much else this turn. I'm going to get rid of this and build a farm. That should give me money and food and solve this fertility issue here. Right, let's... I know normally I would make the faction leader, but I think so. This guy's a landowner, wealth from agriculture, cunning. Let's get you guys in. That would give us a couple of edicts. I'm a bit short on the edicts. Research. Certainly going to need that. That's Pannonia. Moravia. I'm certainly going to need the growth. So that's there. Oh, I have to look at... This is a new feature as well. That these guys don't have to work up the ranks like in the previous games. So... Loyalty +1. Integrity, loyalty. loyalty. So I think we'll get, we're going to be a governor. Actually, your loyalty is quite low, isn't it? So that gives you plus 3 loyalty. So what's the next rank down? Loyalty, tax rate, all provinces. So we're certainly going to go for that. You can't get in, and of course we can't put you in there. Right, research. Public order. I'm going to go for public order there as well, because I've got a feeling we're going to suffer. No, I think that's all we can do this turn. Oh, bugger. I knew that was coming. Now, I am going to fight this. I don't expect to win. Not against that odds. Tiny little gap. But what I want to do is damage these guys. Because if they're going to take a settlement, I'm going to have to capture it back. My army isn't that strong. So I really need to put a bit, even if I can only just damage a few of these units, especially like the spearmen or the archers. Oh, very familiar city. It's fairly defensible. If we can divert them. Where they're coming from? They're coming from over there, which means they're going to come up this slope here. So if let's put a barricade there. I think we'll put these guys here. What's the other? Come to my other unit. There's the general unit. So where did you go, Sunshine? I think what we'll do here for the moment is just put this guy here. Just to see. I put the barricade there. That means they've got to come out and round. There are many facing. Right, I'm just going to speed up a bit. Hopefully these guys will come up. These guys are in. No, heavy shot. Looks like the
odds are against us. We are outnumbered.
Be nice if I could kill their faction leader. Slow it down a bit. So they're getting a bit of fire from that arrow tower, which is good. Right. Let's see if we can drop these archers. Not archers. Missile cavalry. Cheers, see if we can. Saves, I'm not expecting to win. I'm just expecting to think they're coming this way, so I think they might try and sneak around that way, so I think put this other guard here. If they come round here, it's going to be just tough luck. I suppose I've missed the chance here. what I'm going to do now is get you guys over here. Actually, no, there. Because I don't want these archers. I'm quite happy to let these archers get killed by... Come on, guys, shift your ass. Those lancers have got an uphill charge against spearmen. They might.
To the barricades! The enemy attacks!
He's on flaming shots, seeing the cavalry's coming in first. Nice if we could kill their general. Come on, guys. I will speed up a little bit, I think. I think it's going to be a bit of a foregone conclusion. They're going out of range, so... Let's get back to the heavy shot. These guys are now taking archer fire from here, but they're still in range of the tower.
Our men are wavering.
Pucker. They're going down really quickly. These
guys. Our men flee the field of battle. This
That's
is a
it.
Shape. The tower is nothing but ash now.
It's the archers that did it.
Enemy troops are at the walls!
I think it's a formality, so I'll just speed up a bit.
Our men have given up and are running for their lives.
Don't know if you can fight with your back to the wall, but we're just about to find out. Watch the death. They can't find us. Over here, sunshine. Comes the archers now, so won't be long now. Sorry about this, guys. It's killing a few of them. I don't think we're killing many of them. We've killed 6, 7. I think the archers are killing more of their troops than my men are. 17. I'm gonna kill him 14.
The men are losing hope. Our men flee the field of battle.
Well, we killed 264. So we killed more of them than us. We've damaged their leaders. So that's. Now, are you gonna take the settlement? Oh no, they've only raided. Big mistake, Sunshine. Big mistake. We got a mission issued. You have Avar Carganate. Extend your influence and carve out a kingdom in these lands and build a legacy that will last the ages. Do this with eternal glory shall be yours, and all will know and revere your name. So we've got to reach Imperium level 5. So have we already just... So did we actually get that other one? So we're Carganate Rises become... That's confused me. Power balanced. Power balanced. So... Gonna do is get this guy down to here. I can't reach him this turn anyway. I just want to. I think it was Moravia. Was it Moravia or Pannonia? Yep. I hope I can get a farm in here. Get this food because we're minus 19 now. How come it's minus 19? I didn't build anything. Devastation, wealth minus 110, public order minus 6. So how come public mourners minus 6 from, oh, it's because we've lost that, that's been damaged in. So it doesn't make sense. So minus 19. So, instability, yes. Buildings, food, military presence, taxes, banditry. Banditry? Difficulty level, devastation, chaos, religious differences, and immigrants. Oh well. So, I'm going to recruit some more here. I think we'll get. There's me four horse archers. Let's get another couple of these guys.
Come, fight for us, lads.
We can only get three at a time. It's going to be a bit of a problem. I can't really build anything else. That's minus 1. This is minus 19. That's going to be a problem. This public order plus 3, unit plus 1 for cavalry units. Have our tribesmen. Right. So we'll see. There's me saying about slow turns and we're going to
I am the destroyer of men. Better get a shift on.
I think I'm just gonna come to here and just do the recruiting again.
Get the stakes up. We need good fighters.
So, horse archers. I think we're gonna go for that army there first. This army's. I think we're. Come here with that. Gives it minus 13, minus 4. Hopefully that will improve things. Let's give you another spear unit, I think. Oh, it's going to take 2 turns anyway. They've got 12, we've got 17. Can we get any mercenaries? This could all go very, very wrong.
Laying siege.
So I've got some archers, some things. Well, let's go for it. I think gotta be aggressive. My inclination is to come in from this corner, so oops. Just going to line up these guys here. We've got some cavalry over there. And the horse archers. Battle. I think we're.
I want this place torn to pieces. How dare they hide behind
these guys forward?
Face us in open battle. Take these walls, men. Then take their lives.
I've forgotten about our archers. Gonna do is try and get these guys to come in and pin.
The enemy has been spotted.
Get these guys on flaming shot. See if we can hit these guys. And these guys can hit heavy shot. Actually, no flaming shot. There's cavalry coming at us. Get the lancers come in behind. And go after that, go after the king. Try and get the lancers round the back. Can't you guys focus fire on that guy? On melee, start to kick ass. Get you guys to come in that way. We can draw. So you guys focus totally on.
Good.
See how powerful these archers are. Get the heavy shot into these.
Our men have given up and are running for their lives.
Take their heads.
These guys can skirmish away. My general. God knows what he's doing back there. Come on, guys. I think you guys need to get into a bit of melee. Lancers. Get in there behind. Just get in there and finish them off. guys can get in and finish these guys off. Just keep the, get them on the run. You guys can just form up. Come. Oh, that's a pretty good battle. Probably took quite a few casualties. Decisive victory. Really powerful.
Warriors all! For the tribe!
This guy's recruiting. I think what I'm going to do is get him there, and then we can push against. So I want, what I want to do is kind of push this cunning authority. Actually, let's go for personal influence. Tax rate governed province. Oh, so that is, and this is general zeal. Yeah, we'll go for a zeal and cunning, because cunning will get the cost of the army down a bit. So let's have a look at, we've got some fields here. Let's check the public orders getting better. Still a little bit bad in this province. I'm not too sure what we can do to improve it. Right, so let's just do a quick end turn. So I want to try and take out Croatia as quickly as possible. Mercenaries, mercenary spearmen.
I am the wild rover. I
can't do anything to the city, but you can. So we can get another assassination on it. No, failed. I knew I shouldn't have brought the army here. Oh well. Food. If I upgrade that, how are we doing for food now? We've got plenty of food in that part. This one's doing so. Well, right now what we need is cash. So we've got a trading post. How's the sanitation, actually? It's a bit iffy over there. What can I get cash-wise? Growth, trading post, the market. Yeah, let's get a trading post in there. I think the replenishment will work. What's the garrison like in here? Got an onager, that could be interesting. We've got this army here, single general. Got a little bit of cash to spend. I can't. This guy can't recruit. Oh, he can recruit.
Fight with us. It's a good life. Death in battle, there is no finer ending.
These guys have still got the horse archers and that archers, and P recruits and comes in here. Oh, that's good, because if I got a mana, I'd get the horse archers automatically. That's going to be useful. Sorry, I'm talking to myself, guys. I'm very aware of how the time's drifting on. What we'll do is we'll see if we can get this siege underway. Units recruited, rank gained, so we got a bit of rank. Let's. Actually, no, because we're going to have to lay siege, aren't we? Lay siege. Leave you up here, and you can. I'm probably spending far too much money on armies rather than what I should be spending money on, but
to battle.
I think that's all we can do here. Oh, I knew somebody had a wealth from agricultural provinces, authority plus one. Oh, we're certainly going to have that. Cunning, maintenance. Yep, we're going to do that. That might save a bit of money. That's a waste of time. I think I would do the same combination there. And we've got the same rubbish there, so. Oh, I was just gonna have to put the. I think what I'm gonna do is bring this army down. I think I'm gonna go for an auto resolve here because I don't particularly want to assault the walls, and I think it should be. Yep. I'm just gonna occupy. And we've got an increase in Imperium.
Warriors all.
So we've got this army here, this ready army here. Battle. We're probably going to get a rebellion in this part, or that's plus two. That's plus two. So we're holding in the. So let's have a look at Sanic. Might as well repair that. Mr. Hall could be useful. I'm not sure. Cloth weaver. No, I think I can put something better in there, to be honest. And their last. Should be a. My hero in there, if I can see him. I'll get you. Going off down this way, I think.
I hunger
just to see what.
And glory. I'm not going to hang about all day.
These armies are taking a bit of a beating. Can I certainly give you, actually, authority. This is the governed side, isn't it? So we've got to go for that. Which opens up this. I think we'll go for that. We've got some army traditions. Morale plus three. Integrity plus one. So that's the integrity of this army. That's pretty good. Got replenishment. Trading income. 1% replenishment's not much good. Unit cavalry units. Missile units. Certainly, I think I'd go with that, given the nature of the army. Oh. I think, just do this.
Ready for orders.
He's obviously got, gonna give him some cunning. And authority is morale of commander's unit. Oh yeah, give him that. Oops, no. Siege hold out time is a waste of time. See if he's got anything better yet. Armor. Obviously this general's got all the best stuff. These lancers. Probably get rid of these guys, they're costing me money. Let's merge up. That's dropped you down to 16, so I give you a. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're probably a bit over the top with those, so I think we'll just have another. Just gonna have to pad out with spear units, I think, here. I'm gonna go one more turn and that's where I'm gonna stop, guys. Oh, there's some rebels there, so. I think we're.
Getting on our way.
Just gonna auto resolve that. That'll give these guys a bit of experience. I think what we're going to do is bring you down this way.
Ready for battle.
Can you double time it back
when
into there?
Bleed, you can moan. Thirsty for battle.
Have our lancers and tribesmen. That'd be nice. It's expensive. That's a food situation here. Pretty grim. I'm going to go with that. Sorry, I think that would be. How's the religion? Tengrism's increasing because I suppose that's the influence of over there. I think hostile enables spies. That could be really nice. Got food. Yeah, I'm going to. No, I'm gonna wait. I want to convert this. Can't recruit. Anyway, I appoint a provincial governor. Strategist. Doesn't look like it's going to save me any money, so. Right. I know I said I was going to finish, but I think it might a more suitable ending might be taking that final settlement down in the consumption. Oh, bloody hell. So. I'm gonna go for an auto resolve here, aggressive. Because I'm aware of the time.
Ready for orders.
Do an assassinate on this guy. And that is Shouldn't have spent the money on the assassination, should I? Gonna lock that down. That's a hostel, so that's going to 15 wealth from cultural buildings, market town. I think I'm gonna go for a market town. And that is definitely where I'm going to leave it, guys. Say we've kind of reduced the duchy of where it is down to nothing. So I hope you've enjoyed this episode. It's gone pretty well, but I think that's deceiving because we've now spread out quite considerably, and my inclination is I'll do it now actually while I'm thinking about it. In Mossberg, I'm gonna raise another army. Oh, we got a landowner now. Well, from agricultural buildings, actually just check my other governor. Let's do this while I'm thinking about it. This guy's got a bit of experience, so tariff trade agreements with integrity, glorious subjugator, plus one loyalty, moral training for all recruits, commanded force. You're a governor, so there's no point you having that. So I think that would be something good for you to have. This is the new governor of Croatia. See if you've got anything here. Plus 2 authority, that would be quite good. Minus 5 corruption. Plus 2. Actually, I'm going to go for that, I think. Nope. Right, what I'm going to do. Sorry, guys, for. Nope. Plus 20 for commanded armed forces. See what you've got. Nope, so I think I'll give you the. Give you that. Right, we're just going to have a quick shifters at the governors. See what they've got. Certainly you're a governor, so we're certainly going to give you that. Certainly going to give you that. Actually, no. Let's put you back to that. You're going to be the bigger army, so I think you've got melee commander's unit. I think that's going to be more beneficial. Get the costs down. You're a army commander, so let's just have a look here. That's no good. Nope. I think that's all I can do. And that is definitely where I'm going to leave it, guys. Hope you've enjoyed this episode. And until the next time, enjoy your gaming.